As a design engineer, I need to be able to modify gears on the fly. I don't want to generate or download a new gear every time I change the number of teeth, so I need a fully parametric gear. Google and YouTube turned up nothing, so I made my own. I did this for ProE in the 90s and SolidWorks in the 2000s, so here we go again. The two main challenges are creating the correct shape and having a robust model that won't blow up when you make big changes. There is no parametric equation-driven curve feature in Fusion. My workaround is to brute force calculate a bunch of XY locations and fit a spline through them. This is a bit tedious, but not very difficult. The other challenge is that the Fusion solver gets confused when you make big changes. To avoid this, the tooth profile is built up in small sequential steps rather than in one grand sketch. First, 11 points are located and dimensioned with the pre-calculated parameters. Then a spline is fitted with the tangency of the start of the involute constrained to horizontal. The pitch circle, OD, and root diameter circles are made. One problem is that the tooth face extends beyond what is defined by the involute, so an extension is required. The dimensions driving this extension have to be equation driven to account for different gear shapes, so I improvised a variety of equations for this. One problem is we have to fillet this root later, and depending on the number of teeth, the fillet might terminate on the extension or on the involute itself. This will cause a rebuild failure, so I need a single, unbroken surface. To do this, I segmented the extended portion of the tooth to create new points, then I made a single new spline which includes both the involute and the extension points. The next step is to define the center of the tooth and its thickness at the pitch diameter, and define the center of the root of the tooth. Now a sketch is made which projects the approximate spline, the root diameter, and the outside diameter. A single collinear line with the root center closes and defines the profile to finally cut the tooth. Half the tooth is cut, the root radius fillet is put in, then the tip relief radius. Finally, these features are mirrored and patterned. In another video, I'll show how to parametrically assemble two of these gears and mesh the teeth properly.